everyone, and welcome to another edition of Comcast Newsmakers. I'm Barbara Rogers. Joining me in the studio now is Stephanie Martinez. She is a student participant with the Martin Luther King Jr. Freedom Center, which is located in Oakland. And thank you so much for stopping by today to talk about the center. We had Roy Wilson, the director, on another time, who talked about the center and what it does. As a student participant, what do you do there?
As a student participant, I'm more of outreach, sort of going into the schools, doing presentations to get more students involved, and also doing outreach with other community organizations, sort of work together and be able to create a little more change within our community.
So when you're doing this outreach, what is your goal? What is it you're trying to get them to do?
Trying to get young people specifically to really commit to nonviolence, to change, to really being their nobler selves and really understanding that it's not really so much about materialism and consumerism. It's more about being able to change oneself, to be more noble within themselves so that our communities can be better.
How is that message received these days? We hear so much about violence. We see so many images that encourage young people to go for the gold, the bling bling. What kind of response do you get when you go into the schools with this message of nonviolence and non-consumerism?
When we go into the schools and we go into the presentations, you know, generally what we say is we're looking for warriors who are willing to fight all this injustice, because, you know, when you go into the deep roots of it, it's really injustice what's going on with all of that being imprinted within our brains and within our hearts, you know, to say it's, you know, about the bling and the materialism. But when you, you know, when you tell them that, they're excited about it. But then when you tell them about, you know, them having to change, it gets a little scary, because it requires you to be part of not so much of the rest of society. You know, mm-hmm. It requires you to be part of it, but in a different way. It requires you to be in society without it being in you. Mm-hmm. Because the way it is today,
marching
it's really
to a different
hard.
Drummer, so to speak,
yes.
As Martin Luther King himself did.
Yeah, and which is really our purpose, is to really get students to really understand the importance of really being their nobler selves and living in a nonviolent way. A lot of times, you know, we do workshops to learn the steps, you know, Dr. King took and his teachings and a lot of poetry and his speeches, and we do that like twice a month, sort of to get the students to be involved. And every summer we do something big. This summer we did a 7-week tour from Bakersfield to Fresno, and we studied the economic and educational crisis up and down the West Coast. We're also doing something, all of us around the table, where we work with BART Police and families from our youth, and we sort of create a dinner where they can see that, you know, we can be part of each other's lives, especially with everything that's been going on with BART and everything. So we're trying to create like sort of a bond between the community and BART Police, so we can understand each other a little more.
How is that working?
It's going really well. A lot of the families and as are really, you know, when you get to meet a BART police officer at first, it's like, you know, you're a police, especially because we do it with families from our students from Oakland, so you know that there's a lot of tension there. So when the families get to meet the officers and sort of talk to them as human beings and sort of really their thoughts, and we sort of have a game, questions and answers, to sort of ask each other different questions to get to know each other. And a lot of the families are really, you know, shocked that, you know, these people do care, and so it's going really well. It's really creating more of a bond.
Well, I'm glad you're doing the work. If someone wants to get involved, if there are young people listening who say, I want to be a part of that, what do they do?
You can go to our website, the Martin Luther King MLKFreedomCenter.org, or in there we have announcements of our events,
okay,
the things that we do.
All right. Well, thank you for stopping by, and congratulations to you for doing this work, because it's very important.
Thank you.
And thank you for stopping by for another edition of Comcast Newsmakers. I hope you'll be with us again next time. Bye-bye.